पूरी नहीं है। चलो, इन दिस क्वेश्चन दे हैव गिवन यू अ रिंग ऑफ रेडियस आर एंड ही इज आस्किंग यू टू फाइंड द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ ए टेंजेंट परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन। अभी इमेजिन दैट दिस रिंग इज अटैच्ड टू दिस बोर्ड, दिस रिंग इज अटैच्ड टू द बोर्ड एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड see how why he is writing perpendicular to the plane. What is a tangent? A tangent will be like this, right? A tangent will be like this. So this I is equal to mr square, this formula, what to which axis it is? If I take an axis which is perpendicular to the board, if this ring I rotate like this, imagine a rod piercing through the board and this ring is rotating like this, so the moment of inertia formula is this. Okay, so here we have to find moment of inertia about the tangent. So for finding about the tangent, I should know what is the moment of inertia about the diameter, right? If I know the moment of inertia about the diameter, I can use parallaxis theorem and I can calculate moment of inertia about the tangent. So there are two steps involved. Look, they are giving good questions actually, right? So first of all, this formula is about an axis which is perpendicular to the board. Can I say Iz is equal to mr square? Can I say this is your x, this is your y, what z is towards you? So the formula for ring is perpendicular to the board. Alright. Now suppose if I take two diameters which are perpendicular to each other, can I apply perpendicular axis theorem? I can apply perpendicular axis theorem, right? What is perpendicular axis theorem? Ix plus Iy is equal to Iz, right? What is Ix? It is I dia. What is Iy? It is also I dia, right? I dia, because a circle is a symmetrical thing, it doesn't matter which direction you are taking the diameter. You can take diameter like this, you can take diameter like this, but basically you are taking two perpendicular diameters. So I can write is equal to Iz. So it is 2I dia is equal to mr square, or I dia is equal to mr square by 2, right? Now once you have found out the I dia value, now you have to find about the tangent. So I will apply the parallaxis theorem now. Okay, so parallaxis theorem, what does it say? Suppose I call this as it, I tangent. Apply parallaxis theorem. Parallaxis theorem, it is equal to I dia. What is parallaxis theorem? I dash is equal to I plus mass into distance square, right? You know about the centroidal axis, mass into distance square, right? So I dia plus, because I dia is passing through the center, plus mass into distance square. Now this distance is how much? R only, no? From the center to the diameter, what is the distance? R. So it is mr square. So it is mr square by 2 plus mr square, 3 by 2 mr square. Any option there? Now he says perpendicular to the plane. So normally tangent means this only. If you are, let us say, if he is talking about in this direction tangent, that is not a tangent actually. Understanding what I am saying? A tangent definition is this only, in this plane. Let us say he is asking you to calculate about this tangent. Imagine a rod which is from the edge parallel to an axis which is passing through this. Either say kaisa nikla, either say kaisa nikla. If he is trying to mean that, you don't have to do all this, you can directly put the formula now. So what is this? This is mr square, So this is mr square plus mr square. Parallel axis theorem. It becomes 2 mr square. Is this option there?
So this wording is little confusing. What are the options given?
Radius of gyration.
Acha, he has given you radius of gyration.
See, radius of gyration is what? Mr square is equal to mk square. This is the general formula. General formula for any object is I is equal to mk square. But because it is ring, it is mr square. Okay? So here k value is equal to 1. In the case of a ring, the k value becomes r. You have to compare the equation. See, this is the general formula. For a ring, it is I is equal to mr square, right? So for a ring, what is the value of k? K is equal to r. Okay? Has is the answer given in terms of k?
Sir, he's asking the radius of gyration.
He is asking you radius of gyration. Is the moment of inertia given? So how do you find moment of gyration here? Some information should be given, no? Did you write the question? Can you show me that? I'll get a print next time. Acha. Okay. Just take this.
So the final answer, you got this, right? So this must be equal to mk square. This must be equal to, see, finally you have found out a moment of inertia. This must be equal to mk square. This is a general formula. So your k must be equal to root over 3. Your compare these two equations. So you get k square is equal to 3r square by 2. Or k is equal to root 3 by root 2 r. Okay, that meaning of tangent should be like this only. Alright, but it is wording, he says perpendicular to the plane. So if he is meaning this tangent, so I have to use this formula mr square plus mr square. It becomes 2 mr square. It becomes 2 mr square. So 2 mr square will be equal to mk square. Right? So from here you get k is equal to root 2 r. Is this option there?
Yes.
So that is your answer. Okay? So which actually tangent means which tangent I have calculated? I have calculated about tangent which is parallel to this plane. In this plane. But because he has used perpendicular to the plane, he is trying to mean this tangent. Okay? If that is the tangent he is talking about, root 2 r is your answer. Clear? In the same question, I have explained another concept also, which may be useful to you in some other problem. Okay? Just write down that.